many spokes to make a wheel. But it is Christ's desire that the church of earth should be clean, glorious, and holy, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it, you, or I should be holy and without blemish. Let God be true, and every man a liar. Where any two people do not agree on spiritual issues, one of them may be both a wrong. Only God's way is the true way. That is. Yes, yes.
I think every church should have a mission statement and a belief statement.
Have what?
A belief statement.
Okay, okay.
Of what we believe.
Right.
Because sometimes people join church and they don't believe everything.
Amen.
And then when certain things are preached and taught, they'll leave the church.
Amen. Amen. That's why it's so very important. Thank you so much, story. And again, that goes back to what I said earlier about teaching. Okay? And in that new members class, okay, that's what we should have right there, is to make sure everybody understands what they're supposed to be doing. Amen? We talked about that yesterday. Somebody joined this woman, you baptized in the next 5 minutes. You got a problem, y'all. You got a problem. Okay, and if somebody comes to the church and they came from another denomination and they come into the Baptist faith, you got a problem. If you don't teach it, you got a problem. You got a problem. Amen? We know that. What we try, and you're right, when they do baptize, but what we got to do, y'all, on our Christian stewardship and our Christian duty, we have to teach folks that don't happen. If we would learn, how to teach, and I'll say this again, a church without Christian education is a dead church. Because if you don't teach them, they're going to die. And they're going to die and go where? Go right to heaven. Okay? That's what's going to happen. And that's what's happening. Amen.
Amen.
Because there's a lot of work. I'm a dean. But I tell you what, Sister Mara does a fantastic job. they made me some copies, but you know what they said? You don't have a complete one. It's not complete. Yeah, the ones I gave up this morning, some of y'all, I don't think it's complete. Because they made them for me, but he only made one side. I do have a few of them that's complete. It's front and back. It's front and back. I have a few left, y'all.
Thank you. Good morning. How are you?
I'm good.
He's at home with my mom. He's coming tonight.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, everybody's coming. Yeah. Oh, girl. Y'all singing.
Yeah, we're singing. We're going to try to sing. I got a black tone that's
I'm gonna have to figure out how to get an outlet. What? I'm gonna have to figure out how to get an outlet. soul. The love she's at, bless his name. My soul, love she's at. My soul, love Jesus. My soul, love Jesus. Bless his name.
He's a wonder.
My rock.
do something. Let him hear from you. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! You're worthy of a praise. You're worthy of a glory. You're worthy of the honor. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah. I know it feels like revival. Even at the Baptist convention, God, come on now, honey. How many know we serve a mighty God, huh? And he's worthy. Come on, lean on about two people and tell them, he's worthy of a praise.
Topics prison reentry. When our young men and women come out of prison, they have nowhere to go. They have no training. They have no vocational training. So we want to pay close attention to that. It has come all the way from Clinton in North Carolina, by the way of Syracuse, New York. He's been a couple places. But he's still a brother in need. Come on, let's welcome him to the great state of Connecticut.
And the church said amen.
Amen.
To our president, Dr. Kimber, his official staff, to all that are here today, greetings. I got tired watching our sister shout right here. There's nothing wrong with praising the Lord. Amen. I thought for sure if the musician just played a little longer, that Reverend David Wade was going to get saved. Thank God for the spirit that is here in Connecticut. On behalf of our president, Dr. Julius Scruggs, our National Baptist Convention, and also our executive secretary, Chairman of the Prison Ministry, Dr. Brady Scott, again, greetings. My brother and sister, prison is big industry. You think about all that goes into prison, keeping prisoners in jail. It's a revolving door that is not decreasing at all. Our judicial system is not set up for former prisoners to make it. Because once they get out without any adequate training, no kind of life skills, they find themselves doing the same old thing to go back in and put them in the first place. So the prison ministry of the National Baptist Convention exists. And first of all, let me tell you, it exists without being funded by the convention at all.
Yeah.
It really is the stepchild of the convention. And that's why I was so impressed when I had the opportunity last year to talk to President Kimber, who will be our next president of our convention. Out of all the candidates I've heard, and I'm serious about this, out of all the candidates I've heard, and I've heard every one of them, only President Kimber talked about the platform of prison ministry. Only one. Now, it's not in my notes, but in my spirit, so let me say this right quick, and I'm only going to take 10 minutes, because we've got a great preacher coming up out the door. But prior to last year, September's convention, I just thought that our convention was going to let somebody who's been doing the same old thing, nothing different, no change at all. It was my good friend, Pastor Wade, Pastor Brown, who convinced me to go here, Reverend Kimber. I was hungry and I didn't want to go hear no preaching. But when I got there, I was truly convicted that he is the best man for the position.